What are the prerequisites to get into McMaster's PA program?
Anything that you need to know about admission requirements are all on McMaster's Physician Assistant website. They have all the up-to-date information, even the up-to-date information with COVID-19. So really, if we're going to talk about the admission requirements, so there really isn't as many as you might think. And I think that's really something that should really encourage people to believe, you know, you can apply to PA school. It really, not that it's easy, but it's tangible. And, you know, the requirements aren't a long set of checklists, but it's really something that I believe is like tangible and something that if you really work hard to reflect your true personality, and the admission requirements are really not so scary. So really, if we think about it, there's a nice little blurb that outlines it here, but you only need to complete a minimum of 2 years of undergraduate work at the university level. Their college courses are not accepted. So it needs to be at least a minimum of 2 complete years of undergraduate work. So, and then the program will go out to outline what that really looks like. So minimum of 10 full courses or 20 half courses in this span of 2 years, that's the minimum. And so then really on the courses that you've completed, whether it be 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, when you choose to apply, or a master's or a PhD, whatever your educational background is, that's just the minimum. What it will then do is it will calculate a cumulative GPA for the entire undergraduate study. So what a CGPA is if you just think about it, it's an average. Take the average of all of your courses, boom, 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 add them up, divide by however many, and that's your CGPA. And what it uses is the OMSAS scale. And so when you take that CGPA, you need to reach a minimum of a 3.0 on the OMSAS scale out of 4.0. And if you even just Google OMSAS, or even the website has like a link to the OMSAS scale, you can just click that and it'll help you calculate it, just because I know different universities use different grading schemes. So the OMSAS scale is really a standardized way to take everyone's different grading scales and synthesize it in a way that it translates to everyone's grade. So that's really just the OMSAS scale. And then as well, what you need to do is after your CGPA, and then after the minimum course load that you need to take, as well, you will need to complete a supplemental application. That would be using the Kira Talent platform. I'm sure we'll go on to talk about that during the admissions part specifically. So that's the supplementary application. And if your supplementary application is successful, you'll be invited to participate in the multiple mini interview. And then if the multiple mini interview is successful, congrats, you got into PA school.
So in addition to the information on the website, if you actually go to contact information, there's a little handout, a PDF handout that summarizes everything you need to know in 3 steps to apply. So that really, really simplifies it.